Than the moon, brighter than the star. I love you just the way you are. And you,
a world filled with longing quest for wholesome beauty and skill, a quest that transcends through the old and the young, both male and female. To satisfy this yearning comes a name, a brand, Chavit Nigeria Limited.
Chavit is not all about one type of service. We are into fashion, we are into training, we are into salon, we are into hotel management. But each of these businesses, they come one after the other. When you talk about Chavit, if you pick the aspect of the fashion, which is the most passionate for me, I think it's because I love looking good. I love seeing people looking good. And I love having the best in all I do. So I had problems getting all those done for myself and my family. So because of disappointments from, you know, my fashion designers, I decided to go into it just to satisfy myself. Now, when you talk about the eatery business, I love cooking. That's my hobby. I cook. I cook. I love people eating my food. But I don't eat that much. But I love cooking. I could be in the kitchen from morning till any time without complaining. So, and I decided to extend such services to people. And I love good food, not just to eat. What do we eat? Now, if you talk about hotels, fine. Travelers, I heard people being stranded, and so I decided to say, fine, if I can go into that, I think I should just give my little help and service to people. Let them, if you want to relax, you can leave your home and go to your hotel and relax. How are you being treated? Now, the climax of the whole thing right now is the training school. I found out that I have this passion for people to do what they really want to do and do it in a very good environment and with the best hands.
With a mission to beautify, inspire, shape, and transform you.
I got people, you know, coming to me. Chavit wants you to train us in fashion. We love what you're doing. But I said, no, I am not equipped to do that. But I started to give it a thought, and I started with about one person, from one person to two people, and I now began to see the problems, and I decided to really go into research deeply into training in fashion designing, not what we used to have, not the way I was trained. I'm a trained fashion designer. Now, I had to go deep down and research about it, and I tell you, I love what I have.
Behind the brand and mission is a woman described as superlative, energetic, and simply innovative. Mrs. Charity Ayedogun, a chartered accountant, but also beyond all doubt, a successful businesswoman. She's elegant, gorgeous, beautiful, diligent, a proud wife and mother who's also a fashionista.
she's somebody that has this passion for, she has passion for fashion. At the same time, she has passion for those that are ready to work with her, and she has that passion to upgrade those who are ready to work with her as a fashion designer.
She's a machine, and if you cannot move, if you cannot move fast, you can't work with her. She's a machine, she's a creative thinker. She thinks about the problem before the problem comes and creates a solution even before the problem comes. She works like a dynamo. She works like a dynamo. She carries a capacity that she has the capacity of building people and making sure that you are comfortable.
Those who know me, they know me to be a woman that the moment I see something good, I don't keep quiet. And if I know that something is good and it's going to benefit anybody around me, I don't keep information to myself. And what did I do? Because I see the level of unemployment, the level of idle youth around us, I began to think, even some of us that went to university, some of us are not using our certificate to work. There is this thing about using what you have. All of us are gifted into one or two things. We are gifted. Nobody will tell me, I don't know what to do. You are gifted. All you need to do is sit down and think, what part of my life can I use to make both ends meet?
Little wonder she made a name for herself through making people look good right from the inside out. With her outlets like the Chavit Saloon for your hairdress and cut, the Chavit Fashion and Styles for that wow effect on your clothes, Chavit Hotels for awesome hospitality, Chavit Eateries to satisfy that rumbling in your tummy. She had it all figured out, but then Madam Chacha, as she is fondly called, looked around and saw gifted and talented Nigerian youths loitering around town idle. It became a burden. A burden turned passion. A passion that gave birth to Chavit Training Arm.
There are things our government supposed to do, but there are things we ourselves supposed to do. Even for the country. Now, if you feel you don't have money, you don't have cash to spend, why are you sitting down at home? From Monday to Monday, you are at home. Can't you just ask yourself, what can I do? I found out that most people really want to do something. They want to learn, they want to be trained, but they don't have the conducive environment to do that. For instance, you cannot send a graduate to go and learn fashion designing under a tree. The ego is there. I am a graduate. What if my colleagues, maybe they are passing and they see me learning under a tree, under a kiosk, under a place that is not well arranged? That alone will put them off. You can never tell them to go there. They will never agree. They will prefer to sit at home, to steal, or to do other things, other odd things to get money. Now, what did I do? I now said, fine, if I have graduates that want to get skilled, they must have a conducive environment. They must have a package that looks very sweet. Very, very sweet and presentable. And, of course, they should have people like them to train them. Now, if you look around, it's just these days that fashion designers began to, you know, the learned people, we began to go into fashion designing. Now, initially, we used to have old women that teach us how to sew. But recently, I know that we have fashion designers, but most of them are not into training now. Now, I now said, okay, I have to have a package for them. If the government is not giving us something to do, let us try on our own to do something. Let's try on our own. Now, I have a package for them. I have a conducive environment for them. I have graduates that will instruct them. I have a place where when you get into it, it's even better than where you say you spent 4 years. I have passion. I treat them because I have about 11 students that I'm graduating in December. You need to speak to them. I train them with passion. I cut them in. I put them down and I teach them about life. I teach them, it's not just come and learn how to cut and sew. How do you comport yourself? What do you do when you get your money? How do you spend your money? It's part of what I'm training them on. So what I'm saying is, I decided to extend the training, not only fashion, because I got to see that a good number of people really want to learn hairdressing. You cannot say everybody should be a fashion designer. No, we have nails, we have barbing, we have all the other stuff I mentioned earlier. So I now decided to have a package for them for that. And that is what made me to go into having something like this. This is a brochure I designed. I wrote out, and each course I give you what and what you are going to be taught. If it is under fashion designing, you have the courses here already. If it is under hairdressing, you have everything under hairdressing. It's a 9-month course, and I have a degree course. So I decided to write this out, because if you are talking to someone to come for training, you must be able to tell the person what you want to train the person for, because it is not a joke to be a professional.
Chavi Training Arm, a training institute geared at giving sound, undiluted and professional training in various skills.
We are not just a fashion designer, but we are people that think. We are people that research for the things on trend, latest things that people use. Before we carry out any design, we have to go to our design studio. We make all the necessary research that we need to do. We bring down our sketch, we test rod, we make a template of such clothes before it will finally approve that, okay, let's make an amends push it to the market.
Before I even came to this place, if I joined Chavit, I was thinking maybe I'm the best or one of the best. Because when you come into this place, I say, wow, so this is the last bus stop. Because when I came to this place, I saw some machine, some designing things that when I use it, I would say, yes, this is different from where I was coming from or where I was working. And I follow up with it, you know? The things that I use, all those chemicals of the machine, I learned that when you use a bad chemical, it can turn to a hazard to your life or to your health.
This is more comfortable and life. And the place where every necessary equipment is what we need for this profession. It's a place where anyone that can learn, that has the ability to learn, will learn. It's a good and nice place. The training I've been given to my orientations and the way we visualize me, because as a professional, before using your equipment, before using your paper and so on, you have to properly sterilize your paper. And also, you have to be very neat. You have to make sure the premises is well tidy. And also, make sure the environment is free from hazards, of any chemical or material hazard that can cause damage to the client or the person or the barber himself. And also,